accept this report as non-session animal Matthew Stigball for signing. Please make sure also phones are off.
Good afternoon, everyone. Please be seated. Roll call status, Anthony Francis Iannotti, file 16-4845, 16-4827. Good afternoon,
Detective Wolf. Good afternoon, Aaron. I have four charges for Mr. Iannotti.
The warrant was already authorized.
Yes, sir.
And Detective Frontschneider, you're present on the other file.
That's correct, Your Honor.
Sir, state your name, please.
Donald Thumble, lawyer.
All I'm asking is your name, sir. I'm not asking you to make any statements.
I've asked for 2 days to see a lawyer.
Detective, did you confirm the identity of the man that's on the camera at this time?
Yes, sir. And
what is his identification?
His name is Anthony Francis Iannotti, date of birth 12-17-1981.
The court is going to now inform you of the charges against you, beginning with file 16-4845. You have been charged with the following offenses and a felony warrant. Count one is homicide, a murder in the first degree, premeditated. It is alleged that you did commit the murder of Donna Loring, and that is a felony punishable by up to life without parole. You are also charged with count two, felony homicide murder. That is a felony punishable by up to life without parole. You are charged with count three, unlawful driving away of a motor vehicle. That is a felony punishable by up to 5 years in prison. And you are charged with count four, larceny in a building. That is a felony punishable by up to 4 years in prison and or $5,000. These crimes allegedly occurred in the city of Warren on or about August the 10th, 2016. You have the right to remain silent and you say can be used against you in court. You have the right to have an attorney present during all hearings and at all questioning. If you could not afford an attorney, one would be appointed for you. Are you requesting a court-appointed lawyer, sir?
Yes.
We will receive the court-appointed attorney through the Judicial Aid Department. You have the right to two hearings in the district court, a probable cause conference and a preliminary examination or probable cause hearing. And those will occur before Judge Chupa on the following dates, August 30th for the probable cause conference and September 6th. For the preliminary examination at 8:45 a.m. Due to the nature of the charges, you do not have the right to a bond, but the court will certainly hear any position on bond from the department detective.
Yes, Your Honor. He has an extensive violent criminal history for his, by his track record and his criminal history. He's dangerous, he's elusive. He poses a direct violent threat to society. He has an escape risk. I have zero faith he'll show up for any court date. And after an extensive multi-jurisdictional manhunt, he was apprehended this morning by Shelby Township Police after a home invasion in their city. I'm also requesting no bond.
So there's an indication that other charges may be pending?
Yes, sir.
Jurisdiction. Can you tell me what specific prior convictions the defendant has?
Yes, I can, Your Honor. 2002, he was found guilty for domestic violence. That was two counts. In 2004, he was found guilty for fleeing a police officer, third degree. Also, he was found guilty for receiving, concealing a motor vehicle, stolen property. Also, in 2004, he was found guilty for felony assault, bodily harm, less than murder. In 2003, also he was found for guilty for aggravated felony stalking. And there was a recent case in 2016, 8 of 2016, that was bound over to circuit court for felony assault by strangulation.
Thank you, Detective. Sir, based upon the nature of the criminal charges against you, the court a rule does authorize the court to hold you without a bond, and that is based upon the prior criminal history and the severity of these charges. Therefore, you're held without bond on these charges. On file 16-4827, you are arraigned on this warrant. It alleges that the following offense occurred on or about August 10th, 16 in the city of Warren. Count one, home invasion in the third degree. punishment by 5 years prison and a $2,000. Count two is tampering with an electronic monitoring device. That is a felony punishable by 2 years and a $4,000. Do you understand the charges against you, sir?
Yes.
You have the right to remain silent. You have the right to an attorney. If you cannot afford an attorney, one will be appointed for you. Are you requesting an attorney on these charges as well?
Yes.
You'll receive the court appointed attorney through the Commissioner Labor Department. And again, the probable cause conference and preliminary examination will occur on those dates as previously set before Judge Chupa, which is August the 30th and September the 6th. At 8:45, Detective Braunschneider, you're present regarding bond on this file.
Your Honor, both of these incidents occurred hours after posting bond on another charge, felony charge from this court. He cut off his tether abruptly and left, along with the reasons Detective Wolf had described. We would request extremely high of no bond.
Based upon the nature of the charges, set a high cash surety only bond, and that's again based upon these charges, other pending charges of prior criminal history. Bond is set at $2 million cash surety only. Anything else, detectives?
That's it, thank you.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Court stands adjourned.
All right, please.